Hi, this is perhaps one of the easiest set in CAT 2019 slot 1. It says 5 vendors are being considered for a service. The service evaluation committee evaluated each vendor on 6 aspects: cost, customer service, features, quality, reach, and reliability. So there are 6 parameters, right? Each of these evaluations are on a scale of 0 worst to 100 perfect. The evaluation scores on these aspects are shown in the radar chart. Okay, so your key point would be to actually read this radar chart. Once you read this radar chart, your job is done. For example, vendor 1 obtains a score of 52 on reliability. So vendor 1 is this one, right? He obtains a score of 50 on reliability. Vendor 2 obtains a score of 45 on features. Vendor 3 obtains a score of 90 on cost and so on, right? And if you look at the questions, it says on which aspect is the median score the least. A vendor's final score is the average of all 6. What is the highest final score? List all the vendors who are among the top 2. List of all the vendors who are in the top 3. You actually don't even need calculations. You can basically just observe and answer the questions very easily. So let us go one by one and try to solve them. First one says, on which aspect is the median score of the 5 vendors the least? Median is the middle value when you either arrange it in ascending or descending order. Now, we already know it is from 0 to 90 and the middle value can be found very easily. So this will be the middle value here. So 1, 2, 3. This will be the middle value here. 1, 2, 3. This will be the middle value here. 1, 2, 3. This will be the middle value here. Then 1, 2, 3. This will be the middle value here. There is a dotted line here. 1, 2. This will be the middle value here. Right, so where does the lowest middle value come? It either looks like either customer service or this. This is 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. It's almost exactly equal to 50, right? So customer service is the lower value. Question number 2. It says a vendor's final score is the average of the scores across all 6 aspects. Which vendor has the highest final score? Now, all these vendors have 6 scores. Right? And all the scores have the same weightages. Nowhere does it say that reliability has more importance than cost or reach has lesser importance than customer service, etc. So all you need to do is take the total, divide by 6, that will be the average for each of them. So instead of dividing it by 6, whichever vendor has the highest total will also have the highest average. Right, that is one need to do. Now we can add up all these values pretty easily and do it. Right? Instead of trying to do that, let's just look at by observation. Now, if you look at it, vendor 3, right? He has 2 very high leads across all the other people, right? So, for example, vendor 3 and vendor 4 are 2 contenders. Now, let's compare this. Now, the gap in reliability is pretty big, right? And that cannot be offset by features. This gap in customer service is roughly equal to the one in quality. And then you have reach and customer and cost also. So we definitely know vendor 3 beats vendor 4. Now let's check vendor 3 and vendor 2. If we check vendor 3 and vendor 2, again, there's a huge gap here, right? There's a reasonable gap here. There's this gap and this gap roughly offset each other. There is another gap in favor of vendor 3. There is another gap in favor of vendor 3 and there is another gap in favor of vendor 3. So we can very clearly say that vendor 2 is also out. Now let's check with vendor 1. Vendor 1 is the light one, right? So again, there is a pretty decent gap here, right? Here, the gap is on the other side, okay? Here, you have, again, the gap is very small, right? Here, vendor 3 beats vendor 1 again, vendor 3 beats vendor 1 again, and vendor 3 beats vendor 1 here also. So we can very clearly say that 3 is also going to be higher than 1. Easily mark 1 as the answer. Now, the third one again is an observation question rather than a calculation one. Let's see what this says. The list of vendors who are among the top 2 scorers in the maximum number of aspects. So, to give an example, reliability, the top 2 are vendor 3 and vendor 5. Now, if I do the same for the others, we need to figure out who comes the maximum number of time. In reach, the top 2 are vendor 1 and vendor 5. In quality, the top 2 are vendor 1 and vendor 2. in features, the top two are vendor 4 and vendor 5. In customer service, the top two are vendor 4 and vendor 1. And in cost, the top two are vendor 3 and vendor 2. Right? So now you need to figure out who comes the maximum number of times. Now 3 comes twice. Right, 5 comes 1, 2, 3 times. So 5 should be present in the answer, but 3 should not be present in the answer. So this is out. This is out. So whether it's 1 and 5 or 2 and 5, let's look at 1. 1 comes 1, 2, 3 times. So this will be the answer. 2 comes only 2 times. Right, so pretty straightforward. Option 2. And the last one in the set, list of all vendors who are among the top 3 in all six aspects. So you should be present in the top 3 in all the 6 aspects. Okay, so you have 1, 3 and none of these. So let's check 1. Is 1 present in all of them? 1 is present in reliability, 1 is present in reach, 1 is present in quality, but 1 is not there in features. Features, 1 is the lowest. So this is out, this is out. So it should be either 3 or none of the vendors. Let's look at 3. 3 is present in reliability, reach, quality, features, customer service, as well as cost, right? So option 3. Very easy set. Your biggest challenge would be to read the graph. If you read the graph carefully, the question can be solved using observation itself. A must-do set in the slot 1 that completes this set.